Hello, hello everyone, I'm Zwalara. I hope you're all doing well. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Narwa armor set, its skills, what the skills do, for which weapons these skills are useful, what materials you need to craft the set, and where to get these materials. A quick note before we start, these videos took a lot longer than I expected, so if this video was useful in any way, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a like or a comment. Hopefully this way, more people will see these videos. With all of that out of the way, let's get started. So here we have a good look at the Narwa armor set. I'm just going to rotate it around a little bit so you have a good look at the front and the back. In the meantime, let's take a look at what skills we get with the set. With the set you will get Thunder Alignment level 5, Rapid Morph level 1, Offensive Guard level 1, Constitution level 1, Critical Draw level 1, Guard level 2, Part Breaker level 1, Artillery level 1, Evasion Window level 1, and Marathon Runner level 1. However, there is another skill that you can get with this set, which is Storm Soul. The way to get this is by upgrading your armor to level 9. You do need parts from the final boss for this, but if you upgrade all your armor pieces to level 9, you will also get Storm Soul level 5. So, what do these skills do? Let's start with Storm Soul level 5, which gives you two benefits. The first being you'll get 15% extra attack in dragon attacks or in thunder attacks, but more importantly, you get 2 extra points in all the skills that you have on your set. Now from here on out, I'm just gonna assume that you upgraded your armor to level 9 and that you have this skill active. So I'm gonna count 2 extra points in all the skills and I'm gonna try to explain what those skills do at that level. Starting with Rapid Morph level 3, which is an exclusive skill for the Switch Axe and the Charge Blade. And what the skill does is it makes it so that you can morph your weapon 30% faster. You can see here the difference between having the skill and not having the skill. Another thing that the skill does is the morph attacks that you do 20% extra damage. Then we have Offensive Guard level 3, which temporarily gives you 15% extra attack when you perform a perfectly timed block. Then we have Constitution level 3, which reduces the stamina consumption with 30% while rolling or blocking. Then the next skill that we have is Critical Draw level 3, and with this skill you get 40% extra infinity on your first draw. So when you have your weapon holstered and you draw it for the first time, you'll get 40% extra infinity on that first hit. Now if you don't know what infinity is the chance of you landing a critical hit. Then we have Guard level 4, which reduces the impact when you block attacks. You can see here the difference between having this skill and not having this skill. Another thing that the skill does is it reduces your stamina consumption while blocking by 30%. Part Breaker level 3 will make it so that you do more damage to breakable parts. So think for example the horns, or the claws, or the tail. You will do 30% extra damage on those parts. So in essence, you will break parts faster or you will cut tails faster with this skill. Then we have Artillery level 3, which increases the explosive powers of attacks. So think of things like the shells for your gun lance, the Wyvern Fire for the gun lance, the fire attacks from the Charge Blade, or sticky ammo for the bowguns. With level 3, these will do 30% extra damage. Another thing that the skill does is it will cooldown your Riven Fire 50% faster. Then we have Invasion Window level 3, which makes it a lot easier to evade through attacks and through roars. The next skill that we have is Marathon Runner level 3, which makes it so that you consume 50% less stamina. This counts for all the actions, so think of things like running, rolling, or attacking. Those will consume 50% less stamina. And then the last skill that we have is Thunder Alignment level 5, and this skill will give you 4 extra points in thunder resistance, but more importantly, it gives you great luck. Now what does great luck do? Great luck gives you a chance to earn more rewards at the end of a hunt, so you can get more materials. Let's quickly go over the stats. With the set you will get 13 in fire, 8 in water, 27 in thunder, minus 12 in ice, minus 12 in dragon. You start with 380 defense, and you have 0 decoration slots. So, for which weapons is this set useful? I don't think that this set is really useful to be used as is. It has a lot of conflicting skills. Take for example Rapid Morph. It's an exclusive skill for the Switch Axe and for the Charge Blade. Two weapons that don't really benefit, for example, for Marathon Runner, which is a skill that is really useful for the Dual Blades. But then the Dual Blades don't have any use for Critical Draw. That's a really useful skill for the Greatsword. So you might think, okay, it has all these skills and it's not really useful for one particular weapon, so this set is pretty useless. But it really isn't, because there's another set in this game that can get skill Storm Soul, which is the Ibushi set. Now the idea of those two sets, the Ibushi set and the Narwa set, is that you look at which skills are useful for your weapon, take the parts that you need to get those skills, and make a mix set of those two. I'm gonna leave a link in the description to the Ibushi set so you can see which skills that set has, and then it's up to you to decide which skills you need for your weapon and which parts of the set you will need to craft. To craft the set you will need the following: 2 Narwa Horn Pluses, 13 Narwa Curry Pieces, 3 Narwa Spark Sacks, 9 Narwa Hide Pluses, 11 Narwa Tentacles, 5 Narwa Claw Pluses, 1 Thunder Spirit Orb, and 2 Elder Dragon Bones. let's quickly go over how to obtain the harder to get materials. To get the horn, you will need to break the head. To get the spark sack and the tentacles, you will need to break the back. To get the claw, you will need to break the claws. The Elder Dragon Bone, you get it at the end of the hunt as a target reward. There's a 26% chance of getting this item while hunting this monster. And the hardest to get thing is the orb. The best way to get this is by breaking the head, which gives you a 3% chance of getting it, and cutting the tail and carving it, which gives you another 3% chance of getting it. You will also need 2 Zenogre Electro Furs. This you can get by hunting a Zenogre in high rank, 3 Thunder Sacks, and 2 Tobi-Kadachi Electro Pluses. This you can get by hunting a Tobi-Kadachi in high rank. Anyway, that's all for this set. Thank you so much for watching and have a good hunt.